Yeah. Much louder, much more bullshit in the earphones. Yeah. Yeah, that's beautiful. Okay, let's do it. But before I begin, I must say that the collective archetype is getting me down. And you know what I mean. So if there are any desert islands available, please turn me on to them.
We don't go down to New Orleans, we're gonna love, so baby, please don't go.
Minutes only.
Morrison has already gone. Mamzera has already gone. Mr. Densmore is not with him.
Dad, I love you,
We ask all flights and passengers also to ensure that your chair backs are in a straight position and for takeoff. Thank you.
We wanna keep the stage set.
Whatever you want. Whatever you want.
Can you get us some beer?
We have no liquor here. No beer. You want orange drinks,
Frank
Shirley's present, you know, whatever you want.
No.
Do another one.
All right, what do you want to hear now?
Whatever your little heart desires.
Whatever your little heart desires.
Oh, listen to Elvis over here.
Can you hear me, Jim?
Okay, let's hear that little red catalog again. I really look.
Coming at you.
With a what?
Oh, the introduction. Now let's see, you start. Who should come in next?
We're hungry right up here. Freedom at our eyes.
Start the rhythm, and then the bass, and then the organ, but each one just one. Done.
That would be fine.
All right, the cue is, remember when we were in Africa? Something like that.
Don't overblow, Jim. You got a long way to go.
Why not?
Do we have to play that loud? Because I can't play as loud as you.
And on that last one. Well, you know what Robbie's trying to do, right? That sound.
Yeah, I know that. Yeah. Hey, Ray, look, we got to look at each other.
It's the stupidest ending I've ever heard of any song.
What's stupid?
The ending?
Yeah. And that's not the top.
This cuts off. And the only thing you hear is just the... fadeaway of the sound.
Of the sound?
Yeah, for a sound.
I love
it.
Eric, can everybody play? Can we get his ear and what it sounds like out here?
Hey, let's cut. Let's make a record.
Yeah, let's do it this time. Let's try that. Isn't there a six?
How's that again?
Robbie does two, John one, Doug one, I do two, and then you come.
All right.
That sounds good, Robbie. Here we go. One time, everybody, please.
Okay, let's talk about the Doors.
What's the difference between a rock lyric and a poem?
Well, there's really no difference, you know. Jim's book is the same as Jim's lyrics. You know, this, I can read a page, and I've heard him sing pretty much the same things. You know, for him, I don't think it's any difference at all. This is written poetry, and what he does on stage is spoken poetry. Mm. And spoken poetry is very effective. Although some poems read better than they speak, but for the most part, spoken poetry is much more effective.
What we do sometimes is like we'll play a song and we'll play the structure and of the song, and then we'll get into a free part and we'll improvise musically and he'll improvise lyrically, and that will probably be just straight poetry, you know? Yeah. And then we'll get back into the form later.
It would naturally seem much more fluid than what you've got in the book
there. A lot of our most interesting songs develop over a period of time, playing night after night in clubs. We'd start out into a fairly basic song, and then the music would settle into a kind of hypnotic of river of sound, which would leave me free to kind of make up anything that came into my head at the time. I like songs, but that's the part of the performance that I enjoy the most, where I have a chance just to pick up vibrations from the music and what's coming from the audience, and just kind of follow it wherever it goes.
How's that different from how you write a poem?
It's very similar. I think a lot of poetry is very close to music, except when you write a poem, often you have to be in a state of mind that music can put you in with its hypnotic quality that leaves you free to, you know, just let the subconscious play itself out wherever it goes. I really admire poets who can get up with just with or without a microphone, just in front of a group of people and start reciting their poetry. I really admire that, but I find it, the music gives me a kind of security that makes it a lot easier to express myself, whereas it's, you know, kind of hard just to read it dry.
Sure. Yeah.
I wish I could. I'd like to work on that a little bit more. You know?
What do kids look to you for as far as projecting through your sounds?
Actually, it's funny, in Europe that the kids were much more politically oriented, you know. If we said anything politically, they'd go into a furor, you know. I mean, they'd love it, you know, especially anything against America, you know. But if we just played, they'd dig that too, but they really dug the political side of it, you know. Mm-hmm. But in America, it's just the opposite, really.
What do they come to hear? I mean, well, I know you can just say music.
I think they come more for the religious experience.
I think in a way, rock concerts have always served a function. It gives a lot of people with the same station in life a chance to gather together and kind of assemble and just feel the sheer mass of them that exists, the numbers.
And you can take that 10,000 people coming together, and there's a sense of communion, a communal thing. We're all here together, and there's no reason. A lot of energy is dissipated in the concert, but there's no reason that same communal kind of thing can't be taken out into the outside world. And ideally, hopefully, that's what a good rock concert can do.
Do you sometimes see your concerts as a sort of ritual?
Yeah, it's a funny thing. I've read a little bit about shamanism. I haven't seen too much of it firsthand, except, you know, what we see with the music and that kind of thing. But in tribes, the shaman could be any age, could be an old man or a young man, but the whole tribe, all ages, kind of tried to push him into his trip and listen to him. Irregardless, it was just a question of a certain psychological tendency in an individual.
What do you think the role of a rock shaman is in a time of, say, social turmoil?
I don't think the shaman, from what I've read, is really too interested in defining his role in society. He's just more interested in pursuing his own fantasies.
What's the name of this place?
Oh, come on. You forgot it. Pretty so stone that
you don't even know.
Cheyenne?
Oh,
Cheyenne?
Cheyenne?
Will you come on up?
You know, Jagger.
Oh, I'm sorry.
How much are these? $1. Can I look at it first to see the one?
Yeah.
I've got one. I don't know about those.
Yeah, Mick, when Jagger and the Hoop
caught you. How much are those?
$1.
Laura!
Come on.
I think the two basic types of music indigenous to this country are black music, blues, and the kind of folk music that was brought over from Europe, and what I guess they call it country music, or the kind of West Virginia high and lonesome sound. That those are the two main streams of root American music. There might be others, I don't know, but like 10 years ago, what they called rock and roll was kind of a blending of those two forms. I guess in 4 or 5 years, the new generation's music will be, it'll have a synthesis of those two elements and some third thing that'll be entire. Maybe it'll be, it might rely heavily on electronics, tapes. I can kind of envision maybe one person with a lot of machines, tapes, and electronic setups, singing or speaking and using machines.
crowd gathered, his landlord appeared and took Frederick back up to his rooms on the second floor, where he began to play the piano madly and sing madly, like... And the landlord's family was amazed. So they sent for his friend Auerbach, and he got there in 3 days by coach. And they took Frederick to asylum, and his mother joined him, and for the next 15 years they cried and cried and laughed and looked at the sun and
till the war is over and we're both a little older, unknown soldier. Breakfast where the news is read, television children fed. Make a grave for the unknown soldier, nestled in your hollow shoulder. Unknown soldier.
It's all over. War is
The war is over.
Pastor Fred L. Stagmeier, Minister at Large for the Evangelical and Reformed Church. Minister at Large?
Minister at Large.
Good. What's your name?
Fred.
Jim. Nice to meet you. How'd you like it?
Well, I have a little problem. You got a second? Let's take a
break. All right. If I'm not back in 10 minutes.
Well, I don't know whether you know the experience of the disciples 50 days after the resurrection. They had been left alone by the man, and he told them to stay in Jerusalem till something happens. Mm-hmm. And the event of the happening was intense communication not only within their little circle, but communication with everybody that heard them. And I think this is perhaps related in a sense.
I can try and explain anything you want. We think of it as kind of we try to provoke sort of a religious experience. Mm-hmm. You know?
And this is what I'm really appreciating.
In the sense of a lot of people communicating in one room. It's 50% physical. Like the records are only like half of it, really. There's a whole other element of theater.
It strikes me as a tremendous mystique about what you're involved in here. It's much more than anything on the surface. Most of the, quote, the establishment, unquote, they're real concerned about what the hell you're pulling off, and it's suspect. And...
Well, I think a lot of that has to do, because, like, this kind of thing's been going on for a long time, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's kind of like secular religion in a way, I guess.
Well, I've appreciated very much getting to talk to you. And how could I communicate with you in terms of writing?
Easy. Give your address. Okay. Yeah, that's our office. Drop in anytime.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, man. Nice to meet you, friend.
Well, just don't report me to my bishop.
When I was back there in seminary school, there was a person there who put forth the proposition that you can petition the Lord with prayer. Petition the Lord with prayer. Petition the Lord with prayer. You cannot petition the Lord with prayer!
Is
his wife gets so. Catacombs, nursery bones, winter women throwing stones, carrying babies to the river. Ah, streets and shoes, avenues, leather riders selling news. The monk bought lunch.
Yeah, he bought a little bit, but he ate it.
All right. This is the best part of the trip. This is the part I really like. Really like it, yeah. All right.
Thank you.
love you, let me jump in your game. She's walking down the street, blind to every eye she meets. Do you think you'll be the guy to make the queen of the angels sigh? Hello, I love you, won't you tell me your name? Hello, I love you, let me jump in your game. Hello, I love you, won't you tell me your name?
Easy 10 thou.